They can be buried. Seriously. People are buying the places of their burial more than now. There is a difficulty. There is competition in some Muslim countries to find a place. Well, like some of the most, actually, subhanAllah, I met one of my friends in Egypt who's working in estate and lands and stuff like that. And you know, he told me something really interesting. He said, do you know what? The most successful business nowadays is grave trading. Seriously, wallahi. He said the people who said, he said if you really, he said whoever wants to have a good business, he should just buy a piece of land and plan it as graveyard. I said, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. People are trading in people's death. Seriously, wallahi. He said, I wanted to buy a place, a flat, and then I had to call this man who is like a broker. And he said, I'm very busy, I have no time. I said, I met him, had no education, couldn't even read or write. And he's a multimillionaire. And he said to him, why are you so busy like this? I want a flat, can you find me a flat? He said, you know what? How much money do you have? If you really want to invest, don't invest in flats, invest in graves. Just buy some, subhanAllah. So they say that Sayyidina Urwa ibn Zubayr, the brother of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Zubayr, was called by Abdul Malik ibn Marwan, the Khalifa, to go and visit him, and they were friends. Sayyidina Urwa had four children, boys. And on his way to Abdul Malik ibn Marwan, after he hosted him, he wanted to show him around, so he take him to the stable where there are loads of horses, the horses of the Khalifa. While him and his son were looking around, one of the horses kicked his son, killed him, and then Sayyidina Urwa wanted to pull the boy. He kicked him as well, and they decided that they have to chop his leg because there is a problem, and they have to, the only way of treating it is to chop it. So Sayyidina Urwa was really saddened by that. He was really sad. He said, I came to the Khalifa, I lost one of my children, I lost one of my limbs. And then while he was with the Khalifa, they got a man, this bandit man who lost his eyesight, and he came to the Khalifa and he said, you know what? I got through a very terrible thing. He said, what happened to you? He said, I decided to move from my dwelling to another place. So I put all my luggage and all my belongings on the back of a camel and I took my family with me and decided to travel. By the night, we decided to camp next to a mountain. We said, let's camp here until the morning. At night, a flood came and killed everyone, apart from one camel and one of my children, a baby, whom I managed to save. So I carried the baby and I said, Alhamdulillah. I carried the baby and I took the camel and moved. While I was walking, the camel ran away. I put the baby and ran after the camel to catch the camel. The wolf came and ate the baby. And then after I found the camel and I got closer to it, it hit me and I lost my eyesight. So overnight, I lost my family, I lost my eyesight, I lost my children. So Sayyidina Urwa ibn Zubayr said, Alhamdulillah. Yes, I haven't lost my old children. I still have three. I haven't lost all my limbs. I still have three. You have a lot, but you just fail to see that. You always see the empty half of the cup. And actually, it's not even an empty half. It could be a little bit empty. But you fail because you see that. Look at the beauty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how many gifts He has given you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to see that.
One last question, which I think is quite important here. How did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam love people who hurts him? What kind of heart does that require?
If you really care for people's destiny and people's to be saved, their salvation, you wouldn't look at their acts. You know, how would you love your children who hit you and who kick you as children? You look at them as your children, right? If there is a baby who beats his mom and she laughs, right? If a baby is kicking his father and punching him, he laughs and he's playing with me, right? Because he does not forget that this is his child. This belongs to him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt that these people belong to him. النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم. The Prophet deserves the believers more than they deserve themselves. That's why if you really care for people, you would be caring for their guidance, for them to be saved, for them to find the path to Allah. He, salawatullah salam alayhi, said, me and you are like a person who has made fire, and then butterflies come from everywhere and they try to throw themselves in the fire. I am around the fire protecting you and saying, go away. If you really look at the hearts of the people and realize that hidayah is their destiny and misguidance is just temporary. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us all from Adam. And Adam was a prophet. Adam was the messenger of Allah, and he was created in that state of hidayah. What has happened? Shaytan interfered. He did not misguide Adam. Actually, even when Adam alayhi salam ate from the forbidden fruit, as they say, it was a temporary thing, and he repented to Allah. The difference, you can say, between a person who has found his path to Allah and a person who has not yet found his path to Allah is the fact that he is just a person who is delayed in his tawbah. He is delayed in his tawbah. If you see it as this, that this person soon will repent. And even when he repents, he'll be as clean as the day his mother has given him birth. And you must have been disobeying Allah for the past 50 years while you say that you are connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you look at that, and if you really care for people, a bit of care for people's destiny, a smile in their face, good character with them. Who has spread Islam in these lands? Who has spread Islam in these lands? There was no Muslim army that came to this land, right? No Muslim army. Who has spread Islam in these lands? The Ba'alawi Sada, right? The Yemenis. Merchants who came with their good character, with their amana, with their behavior with the indigenous people and the people who were living in the land. How did they come to Islam? They loved them. They loved them. Love is a big power that people can invade the hearts through. But because people fail to use this power, they don't know how to, what is the manual of this love? Their machines of love are not functioning. They return to some other replacements. They use some other things. The sword of love is sharper than the sword of the hand. The sword of love, it penetrates the heart and cleanses it. The Prophet salawatullah wa salamu alayhi told us in the Quran that if he salawatullah wa salamu alayhi really cared for a non-Muslim who passed away, and he stood for his janazah, and the Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, wasn't a non-Muslim, how come that you're standing up for his funeral? He said, wasn't that a soul that the shaitan has managed to take away from me without me guiding it before it passes away? If you really care for people to be guided to Allah, to be connected to Allah, for themselves, not for you, for their own good, not for yourself, then you will find that it's an easy job.
Shukran jazakallah khairan kaseeran Sheikh Hassan for the wonderful lecture and giving life into our hearts. Alright, so I would now pass over the session back to the MC.
Alhamdulillah, I don't know about you, but I marvel at the Sheikh's knowledge and his sharing. Inshallah, can I have your round of applause for the Sheikh, inshallah. I've got a few announcements here, so please bear with me. There's good news here. Tomorrow there will be a lecture by Sheikh at SMU, Singapore Management University, Ngee Ann Kongsi Auditorium. It's in the School of Accountancy Lecture Theatre 2, 7:30 p.m. For those of you who would like to go, please ensure that you register over there at the front counter. The title will be Hubbul Watan Minal Iman, Love of the Nation is from Faith. Admission is free, however, registration is required. Just a little bit more about information. Simply Islam, as you know, it does lots of activities, so we are planning for some program with Sheikh Hisham Kabani, Ustaz Usama Cannon, Imam Afrozali, Sheikh Abdul Hakim Murad, and others, inshallah. And also look out for the program on Ramadan Charity Basket on 9th of August. Last things, but not the least, we'd like to say thanks to our supporters, Knowledge means to order books, Islamic events, Ministry of Salawat, Singapore, and of course, our sponsors for today, to the Walton International. Walton International, as you know, is a prime real estate investment group focusing on the purchase of strategically located raw land in major North American cities. Please visit their booth outside for more information. There is also an upcoming seminars on 4th and 7th of July. Before we close, we'd like to say thank you to you. And last but not least, I would really appreciate if we can get Sheikh Ahmad. Please, can I have a closing dua, please?
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وتحمل وتكرم على سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على شجره الاصل النورانيه ومعدن الخليقه الادميه واصل الحضره الربانيه سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، واجعلنا بالصلاه عليه من الفائزين وعلى حوضه من الواردين، ولا تحل بيننا وبينه حتى تدخلنا مدخله يا اكرم الاكرمين. اللهم انفعنا بعبادك الصالحين الذين حضروا معنا هذا المجلس يا اكرم الاكرمين. اللهم انا نسالك قلوبا بك مطمئنه، ونسالك نفوسا لك متوجهه، ونسالك ارواحا بك مرتاحه يا اكرم الاكرمين. اللهم انا استوهبناك قلوبنا فهبها لنا، واستعطيناك نفوسنا فصفها لنا، واستوهبناك أرواحنا فهيئها لنا. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا وقلبا خاشعا ودينا قيما وشفاء من كل داء. اللهم هب لنا منك توبة نصوحة تطهرنا بها جسدا وعقلا وقلبا وروحا. اللهم اجعلنا لك ذكارين، لنعمك شكارين، بطاعتك قائمين، لكتابك ولكلامك مبلغين، ولنبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم من المتبعين. اللهم بارك في أهل هذا المجلس واجعلهم من عبادك المخلصين. اللهم اجمعنا وإياهم على الحق والخير والهدى يا كريم. اللهم اجمعنا وإياهم بهذه الحضرة بهذا الجمع بهذه يوم القيامة على سرر متقابلين، وارفعنا وإياهم إلى مراتب الصادقين، واسلك بنا وإياهم مسالك المحبين المحبوبين، واسلك بنا وإياهم مسالك الصادقين المصدقين، واسلك بنا وإياهم منازل، وادخلنا وإياهم في منازل المقربين، واجعلنا وإياهم من أهل الصدق واليقين، ومن أهل المحبة والتمكين، من أهل النور يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم من أهل النور، ولبسنا واكسنا وإياهم بلباس الفرح والسعادة والحبور يوم النشور يا أكرم الأكرمين، يا من إليه ترجع الأمور وبه تنصلح الأمور وبه وبذكره تنشرح الصدور. كلنا في هذه الدنيا يا كريم. اللهم اجعل من حضر هذا المجلس من أهل محبتك وودائك، واجعلهم من أهل صفائك واصطفائك، واجعلهم ممن يدخلون إلى حضرتك القدسية بقلوب مهيئة ربانية خالية من كل الشهوات الأرضية ومن كل المعاصي والدناءات الدنية الردية. واجعلنا وإياهم من أهل الحضرة العلوية ومن أهل الصفات الربانية ومن أهل الأخلاق المحمدية النبوية. ارزقنا وإياهم تمام الاتباع لحضرة المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم، واجعل عنا الحاضرين ومن سمعونا ومن حضروا معنا من الإنس والجن والملائكة والصالحين يا أرحم الراحمين، اجزهم عنا خير الجزاء، واجزع عنا مشايخنا خير الجزاء، وبلغهم يا ربنا المراتب العليا بفضل ما علمونا. ولحضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من الفاتحة.
With that, thank you. And for those who like to do your salat, as you know, we've got the